agreement. But you see this motherfucking game they're playing right before your eyes. They've contradicted themselves. So if Jason House could do this right now as mayor pro tem, where he's been fighting and protesting for things to be honored according to the ordinances of the village, but now you see him right before you lead a meeting and do the very opposite, what makes you think he won't do that as mayor? You saw Tiffany do it. And if you choose to continue to watch this and go around talking about clean house 2025, then add .com to it. I'm going to say it again. If you choose to go around here talking about clean house 2025, then add .com to it. And then you'll find out what's really going on. Shout out to the late night crew.
And the special court meeting is not
24-008, an ordinance amending the village code to add the requirement of 2 signatures on check to allow the mayor pro tem the authority to sign documents. This motion is put in place. The current ordinance has 2 signers on our bank account, the mayor and the clerk, which is the right of way. We have challenged that before at other court proceedings. This ordinance would allow for if the mayor refuses to do her fiduciary duty to sign checks that the board have approved and make sure that Mayor Pro Tem can sign in her absence. Again, only in the absence of refusal, because we are recognizing many cases
of refusal to sign, which are delaying many projects to the park district and
other items. So we've been able to utilize this mechanism.
You good, Potato. I get it. I know Miss Gaming got you over there hemmed up too. Shout out to y'all.
To make sure the village
continues
and goes forward in the proper manner.
Since there are no minutes.
And this is a procedural thing that we need, as we've been in communication with the bank.
Or anything like this.
Needed for the bank to authorize these signatures as well. So that's the reason for this. I motion that ordinance 24-008.
What will be the check and balance to know if she's
hearing a motion and second? Any discussion?
Otherwise,
none, clerk, roll call, please.
Creating
trustee Dunwood,
ordinance that
trustee Tammy Brown
can sign all
trustee House
board approved.
Trustee Belcher,
pay attention.
Motion passed.
Okay, and then we're going to cycle back to item C, which is the presentation and preliminary findings from former Mayor Lightfoot. I have a couple of comments. I don't know if any board members had comments before I segue to Mayor Lightfoot.
Told you he on the bike.
I'm going to jump through this for a second. I want to get to the part where Lori Lightfoot speaks. But before we do that, I want to show the part of this live Trinidad Downs did that shows a meeting that happened in 2013 when they knew Dalton was broke. So I'm just going to navigate myself. That's the great thing about being part of the breakdown crew is we kind of put it all together. So I'm going to bring you the meeting first from 2013. And then y'all have all heard what Lori Lightfoot said. You've all seen the presentation. So I'm not going to take you back through that again, but I definitely want you to see this part. This is a special board meeting from 5/28/2013. Those of you who say it's all Tiffany, I want you to write this date down. 5/28/2013. And when you write this date down, after you go get a piece of paper and a pen, and you write this date down, I want you to take notes about what's being said during this meeting. And I want to hear you speak about it during the next board meeting to show that you are well informed about Dalton history. So if you want to talk about the fact that I use the word A in Dalton, and you don't even know enough of your history to know why I use the word A in Dalton, then you might want to take some notes on this section so you'll know the history of your village and why Clean House 2025 is some bullshit. And why you gonna end up back in the same situation again in 7 more years with even higher taxes and an even less valuable house. Other than that, shout out to the breakdown crew. Thank you guys for still being here. Let's go ahead and get into this section of this meeting.
Time ago, but here's the special board meeting from May of 2013. May 28th, 2013.
I'm going to call this meeting order at 9:40 this morning, Tuesday, May 28th. What I'd like to do.
Can you hear this okay? Let me know.
That we all stand and have.
Loud, let me know.
Our pledge allegiance by trustee.
Sorry, let me go ahead and let them do their pledge of allegiance and prayer, which is a contradiction. How you pray to God, but pledge your allegiance to a flag. You got to make a decision at some point. That's why there is a separation between church and state, because those of intellectuality. See, I got a master's degree from a seminary, and I had to study the separation between church and state so that I would operate my churches legally. That's why education is important, Jedediah. So you'll know when you're breaking the law. I did an entire paper, shout out to Wikipedia, on the separation between church and state. I know that it goes way back to England. There's always been a clear separation between church and state because they are a contradiction. But I'm going to let them go ahead and do that. And while they do that, hit the like button. But also, let me know you can hear this, okay? Y'all must know I'm smoking some good shit this morning, Lord. It's some tangents are coming.
Thank you.
You welcome.
Madam Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Trustee Bendel. Here. Brown.
Here.
Trustee Henyard.
Here.
Trustee Hunt.
Here.
Trustee Pearson.
Here.
Trustee Simmons.
Here.
All members of the board are present. And I'd like to read my opening statement. Welcome all to today's special board meeting. We are here to begin a serious discussion about the true financial situation that Dalton faces. This discussion will take place over many meetings over the next several years, but we can no longer delay taking first steps needed to resolve the immediate crisis we face. Let me state the problem as clearly as possible. For many years, Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Previous administrations have hid the full extent of this problem, even as they continued to recklessly spend money that they had that they did not have. When I was elected mayor, it was that they had for me out of their meetings over the situation. To read my opening statement. Welcome all to today's special board meeting. We are here to begin a serious discussion about the true financial situation that Dalton faces.
Well, I'm so sorry, Roger Riley. I just have to interrupt you. I know what you're about to say, Stripe, is quite important. But Ted, I'm sending you love, sending you healing, sending you good energy. Go ahead and rest from your migraine. I don't know how you're doing that and listening to me at the same time. Shout out to you, and I'm sending you all the strength in the world, okay? Feel better, baby. Feel better, baby. I wish there was something I could recommend, but I'm sure somebody in the chat will. We got a smart crew here.
This discussion will take place. Welcome all to today's. It was today.
Now, let me let you guys know this before you watch this. If you are part of the Breakdown crew and you've been here since the beginning, like Susie BW2, the fattest vegan I've ever seen, then you've heard this before. I've not even watched this part of Trina Down's live yet, but I know exactly what he's about to say. You know why? Because I'm part of the Breakdown crew. And I saw the video that I posted where this information was put out there. It might have been about 2 months ago. But Trina Down's been telling us that Dalton's been broke since 2013 for a very long time. I wish people would stop ignoring her when she gets up to speak. Well, they did. When they ignored her when she got up to speak. And then some of us, like me and the Breakdown crew and the Late Night crew, started really highlighting the things she was saying and breaking down the things she was saying during her comments. And then they stopped letting her in the building altogether. So now she got to go to Thornton Township to get her shit off. But if you have to go, I'll send you the gas money. Ain't no thing. But you ain't, this ain't new information. If you part of the Breakdown crew, you know Lori Lightfoot ain't telling us nothing new. We already did those calculations on our own. And you also know that what you're about to hear from Roger Riley or Riley Roger is not new. We've heard this all before. Okay? We've heard this all before, but if you are new to the Breakdown Crew, then this is probably new to you. So listen very closely. And let me do this. We ain't done this yet. Let's do this. I know what we need to do. Hold on one second. What you need, baby? You gonna take what? I'll go this time. I don't have any in here. Let's straighten up our thinking crowns real quick. And while we do that, go ahead and hit the like. Hold on. I'll show you how to use it, period. Let's straighten up our thinking crowns real quick, because there are going to be a lot of people in the bushes dragging on our energy, okay? There are people here who are literally scowling at their screen right now, and if we turned on the camera, we would see a really ugly face. There are people here that are really mad that the little bit of us that are here to break this information down and make this public. There are people here that wish that people would just ignore the situation now, but y'all called our energy to this way back in January when we found out the water was dirty in Dalton. And why haven't any of the trustees talked about the bad water quality in Dalton? Dalton's water has not been tested since 2013. People are turning on their water faucets and rocks are coming out. I don't give a fuck about the politics. People can't even drink their water in Dalton, and y'all want to send water to Dixmoor? How fucking dare you? Yeah, I know about this Dalton shit. I'm not new to this Dalton story. That's why I know y'all are all dirty. So let's straighten up our thinking crowns. If you in the Breakdown Crew and you here with me, please put a red heart and a 100 in the chat, please, after you hit the like button. And if you're not, and you smart enough to sit quietly and watch and not troll, I appreciate that too. Thank you for operating in your self-control. I appreciate you. All the levels of fandom work for me. I love my fans. I really do. And I don't mean that in any kind of ugly way. I really, really do. I pray for supporters of our channel. There are people who I found out have liked and been on our channel for a long time who don't say nothing. So I'm not talking to you. You continue to do what you do. But listen, let's straighten up our thinking crowns, because it's hard to hear things when we've gotten our minds so focused on one person. But I told you, when you look at my wings and you think those are targets, they're actually booby traps. You thought those designs on my wings were targets that you could just aim at? No, bitch, those are booby traps. I'm a cult buster. And these politics are the biggest cults. Jazzy helped us see last night when we were looking at the relationship between Grace and Jedediah, how the politics are the same as the cults. They run with the same exact mentality. So let's straighten up our thinking crown so we can hear clearly and have the wisdom to release the right energy into this situation so the truth can be told, because we are closers. We are closers. When we got into this Dalton story, it was all about Tiffany Henyard. Now it's about all of them. Motherfucking ball buster, bitch. If I could find it in me, I would be a dominatrix. It's just not in me. Love is my weakness. It really, really is. I can't be mad. I can't be mean. I can't be angry. When I used to be a phone actress, and my client, a new one, would tell me, because I'm Black, obviously, and a lot of my clients were white when I was a phone actress, because they actually do spend money. That's why I built porn sites that white men love, because they actually do spend money. Shout outs to you. When I used to be a porn actress, and some of my clients, they don't gave me, you just sat up in the bed. I thought you was in the bushes. Tell Mrs. Gaming, I said, what's up? When I used to be a phone actress, and some of my clients who were white had a fetish for Black women, they would say to me, you know, once we get close to the sexual part of the conversation and I start getting ready for them to come, because I was ready to talk to somebody else, a couple hours into the conversation, they would want me. I'm not a submissive, first of all, so it's kind of hard to get me in that place for me to say dumb shit. But they would want me to say to them, I want you to fuck this nigger pussy. And I was in my Umar Johnson era at that time. And I was like, no, I'm sitting here creating a whole porn site that you about to click on and give me some more money for. So you're going to say what the fuck I want you to say. Let me get this straight. I would say to them, no. She is from Mother Africa. This pussy is African pussy, baby. And what you will say is, what I will say is, fuck this African pussy. Now I want you to say it. Ask me for permission. Can you fuck this African pussy? I'm like, can I fuck this African pussy? Tell me. Because we done got into this conversation. We done talked now for hours, and I done said everything you want me to say, and we right here together, and I got you right where I want you. So I'm not about to say no dumb shit just because you paying me $1.80 a minute. That don't make no goddamn sense. Because you want to call me back. So you're not going to call me back if you say, if I say the same shit every other dumb black bitch has said on this phone because you tell her to. No, what you about to say is, can I fuck this African pussy? Beg it. Beg it, bitch. Tell me, you'll do anything for Mother Africa. I do anything for Mother Africa. Can I come? Can I come? I'll tell y'all the rest of the story later. I never could be a dominatrix. Love is my weakness. It always got to go back to love for me, because I realize that love is the higher power. Part of me being the devil. See, the thing is, when in the story of Adam and Eve, and remember, it is just a story, because it's only 6,000 years old and the world is billions of years old. So how could that even be? But in the story of Adam and Eve, all Satan or the serpent ever did was ask, who told you that? Who told you that the tree of the knowledge of good and evil would lead to death? Who told you that? That's the only thing he ever did, and then he slithered away. All he did was ask her a question, and then he slithered away. Because why is the knowledge of good and evil such a bad thing? See, I had a really good pastor named Bishop Michael Dantley. Shout out to you and your family. He said, we keep doing this dance between good and evil, good and evil. It was never designed to be that way. This man said, we got to understand there is no battle between good and evil. Our job is to live. The Bible says, if you seek first the kingdom of God and all its righteousness, then all these things will be added to you. Well, what is righteousness? Bishop Dantley broke it down for me from the pulpit. Bishop Dantley said, righteousness is love, because Bishop Dantley was also a professor at the University of Cincinnati, I think, or maybe the University of Miami, I can't remember. But Bishop Dantley was also an educated man. He had a degree from a seminary, but he was also educated in other areas outside of the church. He was a Renaissance man, for real, for real. He was the kind of man who could work in any capacity and probably do all right. He used to be the kind of pastor who made people lay down their gold chains at the altar. And then he had an epiphany somewhere in the spirit. Maybe his wife told him, nigga, don't do that. You got to get us sent to hell and to jail. Because people used to lay down their gold watches at the altar for Bishop Dantley now. But he realized that wasn't right. And he taught about it. He taught about the mistakes he made as a pastor when he gained popularity, allowing his flesh to misuse people. He taught about how he used to count people and realized that was wrong, to count the people in the church. But Bishop Dantley broke down what righteousness was. Okay, seek ye first the kingdom of God. What is the kingdom of God? The kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And he also helped us understand the kingdom of God is within you. He taught me that back in like 2002, 2003. He said, why you don't have to go anywhere to get what you need, and you got to stop doing this dance on Saturday night between good and evil. It's tearing you up. It's fucking you up. So now that you know that, I wanted to help you understand the devil a little bit more. You'll understand more as we continue to talk, I promise you. But let's get back to this.
Out there, meetings over the situation they had that they did not have. When I was elected mayor, It was that they had for many of their meetings over the situation. To read my opening statement.
Forgive the hiccups in the technology.
Welcome all to today's special board meeting. We are here to begin a serious discussion about the true financial situation that Dalton faces. This discussion will take place over many meetings over the next several years, but we can no longer delay taking the first steps needed to resolve the immediate crisis we face. Let me state the problem as clearly as possible. For many years, Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Previous administrations have hid the full of as possible. For many years, Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million.
Call him Trina.
Dalton has run an annual deficit of $1 to $3 million every year. Dalton has run an annual deficit.
They ain't heard it the thousand other times you said it, bitch. Tell them.
These administrations have hid the full extent of this problem, even as they continue.
Current administration too. Money
that they had.
Obviously.
When I was elected mayor, it was my hope that I would have a few months to try to avoid a crisis. Unfortunately, that proved impossible. For my first day in office, my team has been identifying ways to save money on expenses and ways to increase revenue. Some of these ideas have already been put into place. Over the next few weeks, we will unveil many more of these proposals, which will improve Dalton's finances considerably. The reality is that today, all of our bank accounts are empty. We have one TIF fund that has $1.2 million in it.
What do you
in
say?
In order to make payroll for our employees this Friday,
wait a minute. What?
All of our bank accounts are empty.
What?
Bill, many more of these proposals, which will improve Dalton's finances considerably. The reality is that today, all of our bank accounts are empty. We have one TIF fund that has $1.2 million in it.
What?
In order to make payroll for our employees this Friday,
I know that nigga didn't
make a payment on our health insurance has $1.2 million in it. In order to make
what?
We have one TIF fund that has $1.2 million in it.
Wait, no.
In order to make payroll.
No.